In case you lost access to your two-factor authentication app, and every time when you're trying to log into your Facebook account, you're required to either approve from another device or use the authentication app or even a backup code, but you no longer have access to them, then in this video, I'll show you how you can log into your Facebook account without having to enter any code from any authentication app. And if you find this video helpful, don't forget to give a thumbs up. And also subscribe to my YouTube channel, turn on the notification bell so that you'll be updated every time I make new videos. Now, if you log into your Facebook account and then you're required to enter a 6-digit code from the authentication app, you're not going to enter anything there. What you're going to do instead, you're going to open your browser. So for this case, I'm going to use Chrome browser, and then you go to facebook.com. Then from there, you log into your account. So obviously when you log in, they'll require you to enter a code, but you click having trouble because you don't have access to the code. Then you select I don't have my phone. So this is an assumption that you lost your phone as well, or you changed the phone. So if you don't have your phone, then log into a non-browser or contact us. So you click contact us. So when you click contact us, it will open up a new page where they'll walk you through a few steps, and the first one is to enter an email address that they will use for sending you information about recovering your account, and then the second step will be for you to upload your ID. Now all these steps, with their errors that you're going to encounter, I will show you how to fix them. So the first step is to enter an email address that you're able to access at that moment. So after confirming the email address, you click next. And now the next part is to choose the type of ID to upload. So these are all the different types of IDs that are valid and accepted by Facebook: passport, driver's license, national ID card, and all those. So you pick the one that you have, and then you select, and then you click next. So the next part will be for you to take a photo of your ID, but if you encounter this error, then you can check the video whose link is in the description of this very video. So after capturing the photo of your ID, so you make sure that the information is readable. If it is not, you have to retake a photo, but if it is, you can go ahead and submit your ID. Now after submitting, on business days, the reply comes in about 20 minutes or less. So Facebook will send you an email that contains either a password that you're going to use for logging into your account, or a new link that you're going to click so as to be redirected into getting back to your account. So you click get back into your account. So that link will open up a new window. Then if you want to continue using that very browser, then you select remember browser. Then you continue. So you have to confirm access to your phone. So if you no longer have access to the codes, you click no, I don't have. Then your account will be unlocked. Then now you can turn off the two-factor authentication. But this is not the end. So when you turn off the two-factor authentication, when you click OK, the next part will be for you to set up another two-factor authentication that will enable you to completely remove. Now here, you're going to enable the two-factor authentication again. But if you encounter this other error, check the video whose link is in the description of the video. Now you choose the method. Usually I recommend you to go with the phone number that you're able to access. So after confirming the phone number, then you click continue. Then a code will be sent to that phone number to verify that you're the owner, or to verify access. So the code will be sent, and then you copy that code. Then you can paste it there. So after entering the code, then you continue. So now the two-factor authentication is on for that phone number. Now you're going to log into your Facebook account again afresh. So now this time it is for you to be able to make adjustments on that. So choose a way to confirm it. Select text message, because that is the two-factor authentication method that you selected. Then you continue. So from there, a code will be sent as a text message. Then you copy that code here. So after entering the code, you continue. So now you'll be able to log into your Facebook account. But now, to turn off the two-factor authentication completely, you're going to select the three-dash menu at the top right corner. Then under the menu, you go to settings and privacy. So under that, you select settings. Then from settings, now under account center, there are three options there: personal details, password and security, add preferences. What you select, see more in accounts center. That should be the blue highlighted text. Then now under account settings, you select password and security. Then you select two-factor authentication. Then you select your Facebook account. Then you select the method that you set up for getting the login codes. For my case, it was text messages. Then from there, now you'll be able to turn off the text messages controls. Then that is how you'll eventually turn off two-factor authentication. So thanks for watching. You can check these other videos that might be of help, and don't forget to share this video, and see you in the next one.